In the previous example, we looked at a pharmaceutical product what's packed in a flat plate. So we adhere the product with a foil around it, and this foil at a certain thickness. And we looked at the diffusion of oxygen into the foil. We started with Fourier's law, and I want to illustrate that you can also apply the same methods to different geometries. So let's see if we have a pill with a foil around it. Similar situation, foil with a thickness delta, and oxygen is diffusing into it. And the third one is a cylinder, also with a foil around it, also with a thickness delta, and also oxygen is diffusing into it. If you want to set up the equations, it strongly depends on the geometry. We have seen that Fick's law could be written as the mass flow rate is the diffusion coefficient multiplied by the surface area multiplied by the concentration gradient. And that could be x if we have a flat plate, or it could be the radius if we have a sphere or a cylindrical geometry. In this case, the important thing is that you substitute the different areas. So for a sphere, perhaps I can do it in red, that's perhaps better. In a sphere, the surface area is 4 pi multiplied by r squared. For a cylinder, this becomes 2 pi multiplied by r multiplied by the length of this cylinder. So now we get different situations, and each time we have solved it by assuming that we have a constant mass flow rate. If you do this for the sphere, you get a concentration, which is a function by 1 over r, over the radius. If you do this for the cylinder, you get a function which will be proportional to the logarithmic, natural logarithm of r. So you get different distributions. Here we have seen, for the flat plate, we saw a linear one, here 1 over r, and here 1 over the natural logarithm. Try to derive these concentration distributions by yourself. Test yourself. It's not too difficult. Try it. Thanks.